अस्सलाम वालेकुम क्लास, दिस इज़ आवर फर्स्ट वीडियो लेक्चर एंड वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर वन, इक्वेशंस एंड इनइक्वालिटीज़। एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस एक्सरसाइज 1.1 एंड इट्स नेम इज़ लीनियर इक्वेशंस एंड एप्लीकेशंस। सो एट फर्स्ट आई एम गोइंग टू डिफाइन दैट व्हाट इज़ मेंट बाय एन इक्वेशन, अ मैथमेटिकल स्टेटमेंट कंटेनिंग द साइन ऑफ इक्वालिटी इज नेम्ड एज इक्वेशन। सो व्हाट इज़ मेंट बाय अ मैथमेटिकल स्टेटमेंट, बट बिफोर दैट वी विल डिस्कस दैट व्हाट आर द मैथमेटिकल ऑपरेशंस दैट कुड रिलेट टू ऑब्जेक्ट्स इन द मैथमेटिकल स्टेटमेंट। वी नो दैट देर आर फोर बेसिक मैथमेटिकल ऑपरेशंस, एडिशन, सब्ट्रैक्शन, मल्टीप्लीकेशन एंड डिविजन। सो दीज आर द फोर बेसिक ऑपरेशंस एंड दिस सिम्बल इज नेम्ड एज इक्वालिटी और इक्वल्स टू। सो a mathematical statement containing the sign of equality is named as equation, that is if a statement is having this sign then that statement will be named as equation. For example, x plus 2 is simple mathematical expression or a mathematical statement but not an equation. But if we say that x plus 2 is equal to 5, now this statement is become an equation because it is having the sign of equality in it. So a mathematical statement or algebraic statement with sign of equality is named as equation. Next we have linear equations, as we have to discuss linear equations and its application in this exercise. So we will discuss that what is meant by linear equation. So a linear equation is an equation with degree 1. So what is meant by the degree of some equation? So degree is basically the maximum power of the variable. So a linear equation is an equation in which the maximum power of the variable is 1. For example, in the equation x plus 5 is equal to 7, you can see that the maximum power of the variable is 1, so its degree is 1, so that's why this one is a linear equation. In the next one we have x square minus x plus 2 is equal to 0, so you can see that we are having total 3 terms in this equation. The degree of this term is 2, the degree of this term is 1, and the degree of this term is 0, because constant term means there is no variable, so degree is 0. So maximum power of the variable is 2, it means the degree is 2, so this one is not a linear equation, this one is a quadratic equation. Similarly, the maximum power of the variable is 3 in this case, so it's degree 3, and this one is a cubic equation, not a linear equation. The next term is domain of equation. So once we are able to define equation, we must know what is meant by the domain of the equation. So domain is the set of values for which the given equation remains defined. As we have noticed that we usually have a variable in our domain for which we have to solve the equation. So equation, whenever we define an equation with the help of a variable, it means that variable could have so many possibilities, and that particular set of values that is going to make the equation defined is named as the domain of the equation. For example, in this equation, when we have x plus 2 is equal to 5, we are saying that x is the variable, and you know that variable could have so many options that x could be replaced with any real number, and we know that on real line we have 0, we have positive numbers, negative numbers and decimals as well, like 0.5, 1.5, 0.2, -1.2. So the variable, the best possibilities or the possible values of the variable is from the set of real numbers, but now we have to choose according to our equation that what are the possible values of the variable from this real line which is going to make my equation defined. I am not saying the satisfied, that is the left hand side is equal to right hand side. We are just saying that the equation must be defined. Defined means that we must have a real value, exactly equal or not equal, this is not important, but we must have a real value for all the values of the domain. For example, in the same equation x plus 2 is equal to 5, we are saying that x could be any value on the real line. So if I take x is equal to 0, I will get 0 plus 2 is equal to 0 plus 2 is equal to 5. Now 0 plus 2 is 2, although 2 is not equal to 5, but 2 is a defined number, so x is equal to 0 is a part of my domain. Similarly, if I take some positive value or even some negative value, I'm going to have some positive number, in fact a defined real number. So its domain is set of all real numbers. Similarly, for the equation x square minus 1 is equal to 10, the domain is going to be set of all real numbers. Now come to the second type of equation, when we have the denominator and the variable is present in the denominator. So 1 by x is equal to 7. Now we know that 1 by 0 is not a real number, it is equal to infinity. That is a very, very larger value, but we are not confirmed that how large it is. So we replace it with infinity. So 1 by x is equal to 7. Now when I put x is equal to 0, you can see that we will get 1 by 0, that is infinity or undefined. So it means that I cannot put 0 in my domain because it is going to make the equation undefined, not a defined value. So I have to remove 0 from the domain and I get the domain set of all real numbers except 0. So this statement is saying that x could be replaced with any real value, positive, negative, decimal, fraction, but not with 0. So its domain is set of all real numbers except 0. So you can see that there is only one condition, that the denominator should not be 0 when we are dealing with the linear equation especially. So whenever you are required to find out the domain of the equation, at first check out the domain if we are having some denominator or not. If no denominator is present in the denominator, then simply domain will be set of all real numbers. But if we have a variable in the denominator, it means there is something that we have to remove from the domain in order to avoid any undefined possibility. So the second equation is 1 over x into x minus 1 is equal to 5. Now you can see that there are two variables present in the denominator. This variable is going to be 0 for x is equal to 0, and this one is going to be 0 for x is equal to 1. So I'm going to remove the two options 0 and 1 from the real line. That is, it could be any number, positive, negative, in fact 0.5, but not 0 and 1, because these two values are going to make the denominator 0 or the expression to be undefined. The next equation is 1 over x plus 2 is equal to 10. Again, we are having variable in the denominator. It means we will check that either it is 0 for what value. So x plus 2 will be 0 for x is equal to minus 2, that I have removed from the domain. So its domain is set of all real numbers except minus 2. Next, we have solution set of equation. Solution set is the set of values for which the given equation is satisfied. So previously we said that the given equation must be defined, and now we are saying that the equation is satisfied. Satisfied means that when I put that particular value of the variable in the equation, left hand side must be equal to the right hand side. So when we say that solution set is a set of values for which the given equation is satisfied, it means we are saying that at first we will define the domain and then we will find out one particular value which is going to make the equation satisfied, and that value are named as the solution set of the equation. So solution set must be a subset of the domain. This is the symbol for subset, and this is saying that the solution set must be an element or must be contained in the domain. So domain plays a very important role. We will further discuss the importance of the domain, because it is really very important to define a correct solution set. So let's suppose x plus 2 is equal to 5 be the equation. Obviously its domain is going to be set of all real numbers, and when I'm going to solve the equation, I get x is equal to 3, because 2 will be subtracted on the other side, and solution set is the singleton set 3, because 3 is a part of the domain. Similarly, we have 1 by x is equal to 7. The domain is going to be set of all real numbers except 0. And now simply the solution is x is equal to 7, and this is a part of the domain. That's why this is going to be a subset or contained in the solution set. So a solution set is going to be the singleton set 0. Now we will discuss the importance of the domain, that why domain is important or why it is necessary to write down the domain first before solving the equation. Let's suppose the equation is x by 4 plus 4 by x by 4 is equal to 2. Clearly the domain will be set of all real numbers except minus 4, because the denominator will be 0 at x is equal to minus 4, and for this I will simply put x plus 4 is equal to 0. X is equal to minus 4, it means that denominator is 0 at x is equal to minus 4, so I have removed this number number from the domain. So domain is set of all real numbers except -4, and for the solution, simply if I take the LCM, as the denominator is the same, so I'm simply add the numerator. So x plus 4 over x plus 4 is equal to 2. The two terms will be cancelled out and we will get 1, but 1 is not equal to 2. It means we are having a false statement at the end and there is no variable remains. So it means that the solution set is going to be null set because no value of the variable could satisfy this equation. Now if some students solve the same question on the pattern that x by 4 plus 4 over x plus 4, simply take 1 by x by 4 common, so I will get x plus 4 in the bracket is equal to 2, that is x plus 4 into 1 over x plus 4 is equal to 2. If I shift this x plus 4 on the right hand side, then I will get x plus 4 is equal to 2x plus 8, and by solving this I will get x is equal to -4, but x is equal to -4 is not a part of the domain, so this one cannot be in the solution set, because if I am not able to write down the domain first and then by checking that x is equal to -4, I could write the solution set. Simply many students do this, that they doesn't check the domain and simply write down a solution set is equal to -4, which is not true, because when I'm going to put x is equal to -4 in the equation back, I will get -4 over 0, that is an undefined term that cannot be solved further. So that's why domain plays a very important role, and when we come to get a value of the variable, check that if that value is present in the domain, then you can write or you can put that value in the solution set, otherwise the solution set will be null set because -4 is not a part of the domain right now. Next we have question number 11 from the exercise. It's a simple equation in which we have to find out the solution set. The domain will be set of all real numbers because we do not have any denominator, for the solution, simply I'm going to multiply 3, or I'm going to distribute 3 over the addition 3x plus 6, 5x minus 30, and putting 5x on the left hand side and 6 on the right hand side, we get x is equal to 18. So 18 is a present in the domain, so the solution set is going to be the singleton set 18. Next we have question number 27, y by 3 plus y minus 10 over 5 is equal to 2y minus 2 over 4. Now the domain is set of all real numbers, although we have denominators, but you can see that denominators are free from the variable, that is no variable is present in the domain. So the denominator can never be 0, so the domain is set of all real numbers. Now in order to get the solution, when we have different fractions, then there are two methods to solve such equation. The first method is simply take the LCM on one side, so I will take the LCM on this side, that is 5y plus 3y minus 30 over 5 3 is a 15 is equal to 2y minus 2 over 4, and then we will cross multiply the statement and we will get the final linear form in this way. 20y plus 12y minus 120 is equal to 30y minus 30. But on the second method, what we could do, we could simply take the LCM of all the denominators. So right now we have 3, 5 and 4 and its LCM is 60. So I will multiply the LCM on all both sides of the equation. So multiply 60 on both sides of the equation, I will get the expression 20y plus 12 into y minus 10 is equal to 2y minus 2 into 15, and the final answer is going to be 45. As 45 is a part of the domain, that's why the solution set will be the singleton set 45. Thank you.